Are you a realtor and receiving commissions in your PA on this episode of Title Tuesdays? Hey everybody, welcome back to another fantastic episode of Title Tuesdays. My name is Kevin Tacher, the founder and CEO here at Independence Title, also known as your Title King. Today we have a very special guest. Jose is a good friend of mine. We hang out at a lot of these investment clubs and we're always talking about tax advice. He gives lots of tax advice to the investors and the realtors in the community. So I wanted to bring him on today to talk about all of your commissions. I get so many files that we're closing that the realtors are getting paid in their PA. What is a PA? What are the benefits? That's what we're going to talk about. So thanks for joining me today.
Yeah, thank you for having me.
So the first thing, let's get basic with them and just explain what the PA is, because I think a lot of realtors, their office tells them about a PA. They don't understand what is a PA. How do they set it up? Just tell them a little bit about the history of it.
Right. Well, the PA, you know, it stands for Professional Association. So the DVPR, the state, allows you to operate as a corporation under either a PA or an LLC. Most agents elect to be a PA. And this way you can be taxed as a corporation and elect to be treated as an S-corp and limit your self-employment taxes. There are great benefits to it.
Okay. And, you know, one of the things I always thought, I got my real estate license many, many years ago. And I always saw PA next to people's names, and I always thought that was an attorney. I always look and I'm like, wow, that person's a realtor and an attorney. That's pretty cool. Right. Yeah. So even it gives you some brand recognition. When people see PA next to your name, sometimes they may think they have a little bit higher level of education.
Absolutely.
So that's the first step. You're going to incorporate as a PA. There are many benefits. Let's talk about the tax benefits for them. They receive commissions, which are due from obviously helping people buy and sell houses.
Right.
So what's the benefit or maybe the threshold of them using a PA and having the added expenses where it may not make sense for them to do that?
Right. So as a realtor, normally you're operating under your name unless you have a PA or an LLC. When you receive your commissions under your name, you're going to be taxed at the highest level, which is ordinary income and self-employment tax, an additional 15.3% in self-employment tax. Once you incorporate and set up a PA and an S corporation, you limit those self-employment taxes by electing to be paid via salary payroll. So, you know, I always tell my clients, you know, once you're netting $30,000 and above, you want to do a PA, you want to do an S corporation to pay less taxes.
And it's important for us to do this video because I get asked all the time, you know, what does it make sense to do a PA? Does it make sense not to do a PA?
Right.
You know, and just really understanding. So to wrap up this episode, because we like to keep them short and simple, this episode was geared towards those real estate agents that are making $30,000 or more in commission or $30,000 or less as to whether it would make sense for you to set up an LLC, a limited liability company, or a PA, a professional association. Now, how would they go about it if they wanted to use your services? Can you help them set that up and give them that advice in order to get that tax return filed?
Absolutely. They can contact me, my phone number on my website, advancedtaxadvisors.net. We're down the street from here in Plantation. Feel free to visit or call us.
All right, and we're going to put his information down below in the comments section, and we'll put it on the video here so you have it if you need to reach out to Jose, ask him some questions. He's a wealth of information. He speaks at all of the clubs that I go to, and he loves helping realtors and investors manage their money properly to make sure you're paying the right amount of tax, not necessarily the most or the least, but you're paying the right amount of tax to protect your assets. So thanks for coming in today. I appreciate it. Look for next week's episode where we are going to talk about if you're an investor. Jose's going to stick around. We're going to do one more episode talking about investors that are either going to wholesale, retail, or rent out properties. So thanks for watching Title Tuesdays. My name is Kevin Tacher, the founder and CEO here signing off, and I look forward to seeing you at the closing table.